Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Taha Ghayyur once again on Canada Today Show, airing on Muslim Network TV. Welcome back to our show through this program every week, a few times a week. We bring to you what is happening in the Canadian Muslim community, the new perspectives as well as stories that everybody in Canada should know about. We have been fortunate to be joined by some wonderful guests over the last few weeks, some inspirational change makers whose stories, powerful stories, continue to inspire us and our young generation in Canada, alhamdulillah. Today's episode will be doing something similar in the middle of this pandemic, a lot of bad news that we've been hearing, some discouraging headlines, especially when it comes to health, pandemic itself, and of course, global injustices we've been covering and talking about. I'm happy to speak with someone today who has a beautiful story to share, something that is not usual, something that doesn't happen all the time, but it is something that needs to be celebrated. And it involves a lot of out-of-box thinking, outside-the-box thinking. It requires a lot of courage and creative, energy, alhamdulillah. So today we are going to be talking to our friend and brother Abdul Qayyum Mufti on Canada Today. He has been involved in the community as a developer, as a community builder, with a vast array of experiences in the community, as well as his, of course, real estate experience that he brings to the table. And he is, mashallah, has led many humanitarian projects as well at many levels of our community across the Greater Toronto Area and beyond. Abdul Qayyum Mufti, or AQ Mufti as he is known at sometimes in some circles, you may have noticed him recently making headlines as we heard about some wonderful contribution our community, on behalf of our community, he made. And we're going to learn a little bit more about it in just a moment. He joins us with a 30 years of experience in information technology. He has earned a master's degree in geography and works as a successful RE/MAX real estate agent representative amongst an impressive list of accolades and associations. Brother Mufti is a director of Trillium Health Partners Foundation Board. He's also a steering committee member for the Halton Environmental Network and the Halton District School Board. And those of you who are joining us from outside of Toronto area or across somewhere in Canada or somewhere in the US, Halton region basically is a region more of west of the Toronto area. So today we'll be talking to our Brother Mufti about his efforts to support City of Mississauga's first ever hospital, which resulted in a pledge of historic pledge of $5 million. And so I want to welcome Brother Abdul Qayyum Mufti.
Assalamu alaikum, Taha. Jazakallah khair for inviting me here. And I think I'm just a humble servant. You spoke a lot about me. Just one thing also, because today we are talking about this pledge that we talked about. Try not to refer my professional background, so I don't want to intervene something in there. So that's not the reason I'm here today. So JazakAllah khair for your kind introduction. Yes.
No, thank you. Of course, we want to be inspired by all the incredible community efforts you have been doing and humanitarian work. And that's what we wanted to start off, actually, by firstly congratulating you on this historic moment. Just to put things in perspective for those who are not aware, just last week, we're talking about end of August, basically, $5 million announcement was made, contribution announcement was made for the Trillium Health Foundation on behalf of Muslim community. And it is the first of its kind, or the largest of its kind in Canada that we know of. And alhamdulillah, which is beautiful. Of course, largest of its kind to a hospital. So first, let's start off with the Mufti by help us understand why such a large contribution was a good idea, you thought, and what is behind this process, this decision, I guess, that was made, and the announcement that you made. And we want to, inshallah, talk to you a little bit more about, of course, the history of humanitarian contributions, and specifically when it comes to hospital contributions that and the drives that you have been involved with for at least a decade. But more specifically about this announcement, what led you and your team to, you know, make this announcement, and why $5 million?
Zakalakh, it's a very good question, Rataha, for asking about this question. First of all, just for the information of your viewers and listeners, this is the first time ever in Canadian history that such a large amount of donation has been pledged by any community. So this is the basically the you know, we can say record-breaking pledge, and I you know, I'm so humbled for the support that the Muslim community has shown over the years, and also after this announcement, and I've got so much you know, support from every corner, and not only from Muslim community, from outside, you know, all other communities as well. The reason again for this is, first of all, our hospitals are the place, if you know that, everyone needs it even before they come to this world. The mothers, when they carry them in their belly, they go to the hospital before they are actually coming to the world, and till our last days. Unfortunately, we have to leave this world one day. So the hospital is a place which is part and parcel of our society, of our life itself. And the hospitals, as we know, a general misconception is that it is totally funded by the government. Mm. So, which is not really, it is funded by government, but it's not all of it is funded. Only 80% of the brick and mortar is supplied by the government. Yeah. So the 20% residual that we have to come up with, this comes from your and my pocket. If we do not come, and besides that, also all the equipment, that also, you know, say MRI machine, for example, you know, if we don't support it, we won't be having any MRIs done. So this is such a dire need, because we have, you know, become used to so much that having that top class, world class facility right at our backyard, you know, we don't realize that how much really it needs all the funds that are required to run this sort of, you know, process. So that's what we have to come up with to support our healthcare system wherever we are. You know, we will go into the history, then I will talk about the others as well. But also, as I said, this donation, monetary-wise, is the biggest donation in Canadian history. But besides that, there's something else which may be the first time ever in the world. Mm-hmm. That is something that I want to share with you. I'm you know, I think you're the first channel that I'm talking to you now, right now. Mm-hmm. I have some lined up other interviews as well. So this is the first time ever that the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's name, along with his hadith, will also be put on the wall of the hospital.
Wow.
So this is the first time ever done. And then again, the real message is that, you know, this such a peaceful message. For example, one of the hadiths I will quote you, yes. We have not decided to finalize that which hadith will be there, but one of those hadiths is that Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, that you are not a believer if you sleep with your stomach filled while your neighbor goes hungry. Mm. So when Rasulullah ﷺ said, your neighbor goes hungry, he did not categorically specify that your Muslim neighbor. So your neighbor could be a Jewish, could be a Christian, could be a Hindu, or any other faith, you know, or Buddhist, or Sikh, or whosoever, or even an atheist. So it's the value is of the humanity. That's mm-hmm. the message. That's the message we will be, inshallah, displaying on the wall as well, that this is for everyone. This is not only for the Muslim community. So that is, and also that we are putting the stepping stone now for all other communities to follow. we are setting the example for all other communities, and we are asking that come on, you know, we are giving the lead, so why not, you know, you come forward, and I'm pretty sure that others community will follow us, inshallah.
Amazing, very, very powerful. And thank you for sharing that. And I was going to ask you actually about what hadith you're talking about or saying of the Prophet, but this is beautiful. Something you mentioned, I think, in your one of your interviews recently, which we thought was very powerful, equally powerful. You said, actually, you were quoted in Misaga News, how we look after those in need of health. Healthcare is a measure of our commitment to each other. This is actually very, very beautiful. Why do you think that is true? Why not, let's say, food bank, as you know, the hadith talks about specifically about food, for instance, going, you know, to bed hungry or going to bed full. So why out of all the projects, and I know this is not something new, you've been doing this for years, Why hospital? Why specifically the hospital?
That is a very good question. The thing is that the charity is the basic, pillar of Islam. The teachings of Islam starts from the charity. And then even Rasulullah, I'll quote another hadith there, Rasulullah said that even a smile to your brother is charity. So, you can do whatever you can to help the humanity wherever you are. As you said very rightly, help the food banks, even help the, blood donation, who you help wherever you can. So it's not that when we are committing to the hospital, we are stopping all other avenues. No, we should continue because they all need your help, our help. So we are saying that this one we are going to fulfill, but also don't stop other doors. Let those also, go on without any hindrance. So then again, as a concept of charity, we see this sadaqa jariya. Sadaqa jariya, as you understand, that is something of benefit that's going to benefit the human being even after you leave this dunya, after you leave the world. That's going to keep adding the hasanat in your book of deeds. So that is the concept from Islam that we say that you don't worry about that you're going to reap the rewards here, but you're going to get the rewards in the hereafter as well. So if you help someone today, that's going to be added into even after your life as well. So yes, this sadaqa jariya concept is very important, which I mentioned actually in the announcement as well, that yes, we are the core, of the Islamic teaching is the charity. That every adult Muslim, whoever saves more than his requirements, he or she has to pay 2.5% as zakah. Yes. So there's a mandatory, charity that every Muslim had to pay if they have anything savings other than their own requirements. So we are asked every time and again to help the humanity wherever we are, in whichever form we can. So again, I'm emphasizing here, this is one project we are asking, but also other avenues are open. In addition to that, I will encourage all your viewers to also please continue to support all the avenues that they are doing right now. Even think about something else too.
Excellent, very good. Thank you for sharing that. So, mashallah, you have been involved with this, contributions to the hospital with these campaigns for quite some time. I believe for about 10 years, you've been organizing the Family Day Walkathon that is usually organized, in Mississauga on Family Day weekend or around that time. Yeah. So tell us a bit about, take us back about 10 years and tell us how this whole idea started. Why was this so important to you? And we'll talk a little bit more specifics in a minute, inshallah, about it. But tell us about where did this idea come from? And is there an organization that runs it, this whole project? So how does this work?
Before I go and specify the details about this project that you just mentioned, I just want to acknowledge that the Muslim community has been so generous. And there are examples after example. There are so many organizations, there are so many individuals, they are involved in charitable work. and they've been supporting different wherever they can. I just want to name a few here. It's not the exhausted list, but some of them, just like Imam Dr. Hamid Salimi, he has been helping Osler Hospital in Brampton. Brother Khalid Usman, he's been doing wonderful work in to help the Markham Hospital. Brother Shakir, recently you have heard that he has given the multi-million donation to the hospital. Brother Fasi Sayed, with his team in UIC, they have been helping the Credit Valley Hospital, and they are doing a blood donation and many other things as well. Brother Shahid Mughal, he just recently conducted a blood donation clinic. He's been very active in Mississauga. Then again, the Mississauga Muslim community, which I will talk about in more detail. In Scarborough also same thing, Scarborough Muslim community. Then ICNA Relief, they have donated almost $250,000 just at the start of the pandemic of COVID-19. They donated almost $250,000 to three hospitals in Mississauga, in Brampton, and Brantford as well. And there is Islamic Relief, there is Mercy Mission. There are so many other organizations, and all the masajid, they have been involved with humanitarian aid wherever they can. So I just want to share that it's not only one individual is doing it. There are many, many brothers and sisters and organizations are involved in that. So acknowledging all those, superhumans, I can say, and the organizations, I will just come back to the origin of the Family Day Walkathon. Now, what happened was in 2010, the government of Ontario had announced the Family Day long weekend in February. So then our brothers sisters in ICNA, they thought about why don't it's been announced, so why don't we do something for the family so we can have some program. So they came to me and they said, I said, okay, let me think about it and we'll do something. So then we thought about helping different organizations. Then again, as I said in the beginning, the hospital is a place where we go before our birth till our death. So we thought that this is the best place we can help. And of course, at that time, Credit Valley needed the funds for their expansion. So we started the walkathon on the Family Day weekend, as you just mentioned, that this was the out-of-box thinking, because nobody walks in the middle of the winter in the month of February, right? So when we started the first walk, it was snow all over, and then we were walking. And the first time we walked around the Aramil Town Center, by the way. And then last 9 years, we've been walking around the city center. So the family, the weekend happens to be in February. So we have no choice just to, And the reason for having it on the Family Day weekend was that also to educate the communities, not only Muslim community, but all others as well, that this is the family is the basic building block of the society. And if we have a solid family, we have a solid community. So that's what the idea. So what we used to do was that we always do that. We make a theme of the day, and then also we give a topic for everyone from, and we invite people from every faith, the people from Jewish faith, from the Christian, the Hindus, the Sikhs, and everybody comes in there, the Buddhist, everybody comes there. So I'll give you one example of the topic was the seniors. Okay. And then we had a slogan for the seniors. The seniors have silver in their hair and gold in their heart. Mm-hmm. So that was a kind of encouragement. We want to show that how to respect our seniors, how we can help our seniors, and so on. So apart from collecting the fund, the idea was to educate the communities as well. So what happened that, the first time when we had no, pledge or nothing, alhamdulillah, we were able to raise $45,000 in one program. So then we pledged $250,000, which we finished before the time of the pledge. We pledged for 5 years. We finished almost in 2.5 years. Nice. Then also getting encouraged from then, we pledged another $250,000, which we are working on that. We are close to that. So it's $500,000 pledge. But also this concept was a model. We said that, okay, go ahead and do it in your own cities. Just simply say Muslim community and write the name of the city before that. So for example, we started in Mississauga, we said Mississauga Muslim community. And then we started in Scarborough, and we said the Scarborough Muslim community. And for your information, the Scarborough Muslim community has already raised $250,000 for the Scarborough Rouge Hospital. So we are also starting in Brampton as well with the Brampton Muslim community. Mm-hmm. Just a few days back, I had actually talked before also, but I also got another call from, a couple of days back that please come to Calgary to start the Calgary Muslim community over there. And inshallah, soon maybe I will be traveling there, to start over there. So that is a concept from the Muslim community. Wherever you are, just be part of the society and be, a positive member of the society, basically, and to help wherever you can. So it's one is that, yes, of course, hospitals, but wherever you can, you can help anyone. So that's the main concept.
Amazing. That's beautiful. So you're also on the board of the Trillium Health Partners. So how has that experience been so far? And how did you end up getting involved at the board level of such a prestigious organization of hospitals?
Yes, while we were working on helping the hospital and one day, the hospital board, CEO came to me and said that we'll be, very pleased if you can join our board. So, and then I said, okay, give me some time. I can think about that, whether will I be able to fulfill, the requirements or not. But I thought about it and said, okay, maybe I think it's a good platform where I can contribute, towards the, helping the hospital. So since then, I've been the part of the board, which runs the three hospitals, Credit Valley Hospital and Trillium Hospital, Mississauga, and also on the, the third hospital also near Etobicoke. So it's been a wonderful experience. We discuss about the challenges that we face, especially I'm the board member of the Trillium Health Partners Foundation, which actually helps the hospital. The hospital is the Trillium Health Partners, and the foundation is the one that raises the funds to help the hospital. So there we discuss how we can help our hospital, keep running our hospital, and how we can improve upon the facilities that we offer to our communities around. So it's a very, very rewarding experience, I can say. And this is the part of this pledge also was also that we discuss about it, because I was in the board, so I came to know what are the needs of the hospital and how big a need of the hospital is. Because you see, it's going to be the redevelopment of the new hospital. So it's a big ask. So then I thought that why not, at least whatever we can do in our capacity, so we should pitch in. If I were not in the hospital, know actually the details. Since I were in the hospital board, so then I was able to know exactly the needs and how dire need it is, and so that we could, okay, we can bring our community together. Also, again, it's a very rewarding, in a sense, that Muslim community is a very, as I said, generous community. They always come up, to help wherever they can. So again, this is a recognition of the Muslim community as well, that they have been generous, and this is the first time ever they are making such a big pledge. And inshallah, I'm pretty sure this pledge is for the 10 years. But I'm very confident with our support, with Allah's rahmah, and with this, as I said, the Prophet's name and his hadith will also be there, inshallah. And I have no doubt that it's going to be completed much earlier, much sooner than we applied for.
Well, that's incredible. And inshallah, I hope, our community does come out to support this initiative over the next few years and make sure that we are able to fulfill this pledge, way before the timeline that you have set out for it, inshallah. And that we will be sharing, of course, towards the end, more information about how people can contribute towards this, very, very critical contribution and pledge. I wanted to also ask you, ever since you've been involved with this specific campaign, what kind of reaction have you received from first of all, the Muslim community? And I'll talk to you about in just a moment about the wider community, but starting with the Muslim community, what were some of the reactions and what were some of the challenges you faced when you first started, this whole idea of, Mississauga Muslim community raising, $250,000 or whatever amount it would have been in the beginning for the, let's say, Credit Valley Hospital or any of the hospitals. What kind of challenges you face and what kind of support you got from the Muslim community?
I'm very, very, very humbled. I'm very thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we honestly, in such a way, I can say we didn't face any challenges in a way. Yes, we did educate our people. I just did it in the beginning as well, that many people have misconception. Why hospitals? Why don't you do something else? We are there to help for sure, but hospital is funded by the government as well. So why do we need to, help for the hospital only? So that is why, that's a little challenge. But that, again, education experience. We educated the people, and people very, understood that there is a need for that. Without helping the hospital, we won't be able to receive that kind of, level of excellent service that we receive from the hospitals. It won't be possible. So that was the, only challenge I can say. Otherwise, we've been blessed. As I said, we did not have any target in the beginning, and for the very first program, we raised almost $45,000, which was amazing. And everybody was so pleased and so humbled with this experience and the support. I think it's overwhelming support that we have received from every corner, wherever, from the Muslim community and even beyond. We did receive, some funds from the other communities as well. Because the idea was that the concept is that we are, not only asking for Muslim community, but we are educating everybody who lives around us. So they are also, the generous, community members who come forward and help us.
Amazing. So just going back to your, going back to this particular donation and milestone, at this announcement ceremony, you had, mashallah, some, big guns there. I mean, you had the former mayor of Mississauga, Hazel McCallion. You had Bonnie Crombie, the current mayor. You had Doug Ford, the premier. I mean, it's not very often that all these folks come together to make an announcement. How was their reaction on a personal level when you spoke to them, when they came to know about this? Is there anything you want to share with us? What were some of the sentiments that were shared with you? And not only them, but also other officials from the city, from the hospital community. What were some of the, words of support or any reactions or sentiments that were shared with you?
Absolutely. It's been an amazing journey, I can say. The concept of this thing doesn't happen in one day. Working, and my other colleagues were working on almost like a couple of years or so. It was in the making, but we were just moving forward, so slowly and gradually. But then definitely for the final announcement, we did the announcement in the city hall, by the way, as you have heard that, and you have seen the videos as well. And our mayor, Bonnie Crombie, has been always such a support. She was so pleased, and she made it a point that the announcement is going to be happening from the city hall. And she was really gracious to throw her support, as has been always. Hazel McCallion, I mean, as you know, she's a living legend, and she is so amazing, and I'm always impressed by her energy. When she comes in, she really boosts everyone around her. when we actually organized the very first walkathon from the Mississauga Muslim community, at that time our guest of honor was Hazel McCallion. And she also mentioned that up to this point, no other community or no other individual has recognized the Family Day Walkathon, but you guys have done that first time. And since then, since almost like now 10, 11 years, since then, she's been so supportive of this initiative. And, when we're going to announce, then I said, okay, I want to invite her too. And the moment she heard, she's right on, jumped on it. I said, I'm always behind this project. I'm going to support fully. And when she came in the hospital on the launch day, and she spoke so eloquently and so, she was feeling from the heart. And she was praising the Muslim community that what we have done so far and what we are committed to do so. Now, talking about our premier, Doug Ford, he was absolutely thrilled. And he said that you ask me any support you need, we are there, and my team is here. Actually, we didn't invite any other MPPs or MPs in this program because of the COVID and many other things. Also, there is again question about you invited him or not me. So we didn't want to make it any sort of a controversial thing. But he himself brought all the MPPs along with him. And he said, I'm proud that I have my team here who was working here. And personally, he talked to me, he said, tell me anything, I'm just a call away. So that is overwhelming support. And again, I have to thank my, the board team as well, our CEO, Caroline Ricebrook, she is the award-winning CEO in Canada, by the way. Mm-hmm. And her words are, that she's the number one CEO maybe in the charitable organization in Canada, by the way. Wow. She was before a CEO of a very big organization, and she said that I have seen so many announcements, pledges like that, but I am overwhelmed with the response that we have seen today. So this was her response, and yeah. Along with that, I have big team at the hospital foundation, Kathleen Simon there, forgive me if I forgot the names, right now there is also Carolyn, there is also Nicole and Shannon, and there's so many people, and also from the hospital itself, the director of the hospital, CEO of the hospital, and there are so many, I even can't remember all the names right now here, but a fabulous team we have received, we have actually in the hospital foundation, and they are working day and night. Even on the weekends, I've been in touch with them. We are going back and forth, and then they are, believe me, you can imagine Caroline Ricebrook, she is the CEO. She was actually on vacation. She was in the cottage, and she drove from the cottage to the hospital for this ceremony only.
That's amazing.
So you were talking about the support. So this is the kind of support, and the words of appreciation. They're so much appreciated all the time, that the Muslim community has come forward and took upon them such a big pledge, and they're all impressed.
Wow, that's beautiful, mashallah. So Brother Mufti, one of the question that I'm sure comes, you hear probably often yourself, and I've heard from some people as well, saying that, why did you, I guess, deliberately decide to use the term Muslim community or from the Muslim community? Like, for instance, you make in your announcement and the press in announcements and conference, you mentioned that this gift shows the Muslim community's commitment to its faith and long-term health of the city and the region. So why is it important for you to use Muslim community term and not maybe a specific organization that you represent? And with that also comes this idea or question which some people have asked, is that, how can one person or a group of people claim to represent the entire Muslim community? So I just wanted to hear your thoughts on this and see what you have to say.
Very good. Thank you, Taha, for asking this important question. The thing is, first of all, even from the Mississauga Muslim community, when we organize these programs, Mississauga Muslim community is not an organization also. I just didn't want to create an organization and just to be limited to that organization. Many people ask me that, you got a model now, you got all everything here. So why don't we, register this as an organization? My answer has always been that our focus is on the, on the project, on the, that bringing all the members of the community together, regardless of individuals or organizations, their affiliations or whatsoever. If you say La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, you are the part of the Muslim community. So if we create an organization, then unfortunately our human nature is our shortcomings, being a human, we tend to be now more concerned about that I am the president, I am the secretary general, I am the spokesperson or whatsoever it is. So I thought that, you know, instead of deviating our focus, you know, why don't we just simply say it's your project? You know, if you're an organization, you will be recognized, inshallah. If you're an individual, you will be recognized, you know, whenever you're contributing it at your level. So inshallah. So that's why I'm saying that it's a message for everybody. Now, again, when we come to this one, you know, we specifically said Muslim community. We didn't even say Mississauga Muslim community. The reason is that we also want to make it, you know, as a national, even beyond our borders as well. Wherever you are, even in, you know, you're in Vancouver, you're in Calgary, or you're in Quebec, or wherever you are, you know, you belong to Muslim community. This is your project. And even beyond borders, if you live in anywhere in a part of the world, I'm not going to name any specific one, but if you are a Muslim community, this is your project. And as I say that, you are the owner of this project. It's not me or any individual or any organization. So anyone can take a lead, you know, and they can go on. And by the way, for your information, whoever you know, pledges a certain amount, their names will be recognized at the hospital wall. So there'll be donors wall. So anybody pledges, let's say $20,000 or $50,000 or $100,000 or whatever it is. So there are certain levels. According to that level, their individual organization or their individual name will be recognized. So again, this is not just one individual. We are saying that this project belongs to every one of you.
Amazing. Amazing. That's great. Coming back to your own personal motivation to be involved in not only this project, but you do a lot of interfaith work. You sit on several boards. I know, mashallah, do quite a bit of interfaith diversity type of work as well. I wanted to ask you, what are your, I guess, what moves you? What are your top motivations to continue doing all this work while, of course, you have family, you have your work, your business. Despite all that, you know, you are, mashallah, leading this project for over 10 years. What continues to move you to, you know, keep doing this at a personal level?
See, our leader, our mentor, our messenger, and the role model is our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So when he says that moments, you know, today should be better than yesterday, and tomorrow should be better than today. So that is the, and again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Noble Quran, "Kullu nafsin za'iqatul maut," that every human being will taste death. So one day we have to leave. So we don't have enough time, you know, we don't know when we are going to leave. So it's better to utilize the best of your time so that you can get the reward in the hereafter, inshallah. Not only here, but also in the hereafter. So that is the kind of, you know, at least the mindset we should have always, that, you know, this time, you know, we can sit in front of the TV and flip the channels, you know, and that is one way of doing it. But on the other side, also taking care of your family, your colleagues, your neighbors, and so on and so forth. And also another, you know, hadith, a beautiful hadith of Prophet ﷺ, he said that I am sent in the world to perfect the character. So our character should speak louder than our words. So whatever I say to everyone, that it doesn't matter that you should wait for somebody to take on a big project, or you try to make something big. You know, wherever we are, whichever domain we can work in, just, you know, do it. You know, just not wait it. Just do it and get it done. So that is a way we can utilize our time to the best of our efforts. So that's why, you know, that's the motivation from Rasulullah ﷺ always. And again, that's the motivation for this project as well, that the Rasulullah ﷺ's name, inshallah, will be you know, put on the wall with his hadith. And this is the message, universal message. It's not for Muslim community. It's for everyone to follow the lead that Rasulullah ﷺ has encouraged all of us to help the humanity at large. So this is a beautiful message of peace that, you know, inshallah, we have to spread all across, that, you know, we are, you know, a positive member, you know, productive members of the society, wherever we are, in whichever condition we are, but we are always willing and able to help everyone.
Amazing. So, and thanks for sharing that. Jazakallah khair. Very inspirational. For those of us, you know, our younger generation now, mashallah, mm-hmm. many of them are, you know, becoming active, trying to do good things in the community. They're beautiful, you know, examples of people in our younger generation, millennials even, they're thinking about or themselves are leading some great projects in the community. What advice do you have with, you know, given your experience now with over 10 years, especially with this project and of course, other things that you've been involved with, what advice do you have for those people who, you know, who would like to be involved in such a similar or maybe different civic engagement projects? And you talked about, you know, giving back to humanity, you talked about being a productive member of society. What advice do you have for Canadian Muslims and young Canadian Muslims when it comes to their engagement for engagement in and with such civic engagement projects in the future?
Thank you, Zakala Khair, for such a beautiful question. I would say, Taha, yourself is the, you know, living example of the youth. I know you from, you know, from the, your childhood, mashallah, and you were involved in the Young Muslims, and then now, mashallah, where you are today, mashallah, you got a great respect from the community. So there's a living example in yourself too. So that's why I ask my youth, especially. It's good that you asked me this question, that, you know, I am addressing to all the MSAs or the youth organizations and whoever they are, you know. So please come forward. We will have a good discussion. You take the lead. You own this project, inshallah. And we will give you full support, inshallah, to groom you also, to give you the ways that you can do. And even, I would say, learn from the youth also. We learn from them, you know. So new technology. I'm an IT professional, by the way, but still there is the technology moves on. So I would love to hear from our youth. I invite them all to get on board for this project and any other project if they like to. You know, we are here to, inshallah, guide our youth. And inshallah, you know, their energy, you know, will bring a much more energy in the whole project. And also we can, I think, start even much bigger project even than this as well. So mm-hmm. Thank you for asking this question. And I address our youth that please come forward and take the lead. We will be behind you, giving you support, inshallah.
MashaAllah, that's a beautiful spirit. So what is the best way for people to get in touch with your organization or your group? So if there are young people or anybody else who would like to maybe get involved, whether it's as a volunteer or to support in some other way, and we'll talk, I'll just ask you right after this about the donation part, but specifically about volunteering or just learning about your project, maybe starting off something similar, as you said, in other cities. What is the best way of getting hold of you or somebody else within your organization?
Yeah, we have already created a Facebook page, by the way, with the name of Muslim Community.
Okay.
So if you go onto that, you know, we are trying to upgrade that. I know it's just like recently, so we will keep on upgrading that as well. For now, you can have my personal, cell phone, that you can reach always, 416-908-5600. And email also is info@aqmufti, my name, without any dots or space, .com. So for now, you can do that. But later on, inshallah, we'll be, setting up a website as well. We'll be having a volunteer form as well and so on. But for now, you can use these two contacts, you know.
Okay, that's excellent. Very good. So now let's, as we conclude, just a couple of questions we wanted mm-hmm. to talk to you about. One was, if I'm a business person, mm-hmm. what options do I have, and what kinds of amounts are we talking about when it comes to donations? Let's say if I'm a business person and I have a capacity, I want to make a contribution, and it will probably give me some tax break as well. Sure. What would you say to a person who is watching and has a capacity to give some significant amount for a cause like this?
No, see, first of all, all the donations are given right on the hospital's website, hospital foundation website. There is no third party involved. You're not going to give me anything, any cash or something. Anybody who wants to donate something, they will go right on the Trillium Health Partners Foundation website. There's a page already developed there, and there is a link to how to donate. You already got it on the screen as well. So as soon as you make the donation, immediately you will get the tax deductible receipt right from the hospital. So there is no third party involved, no organization, no individual who's going to collect money from you. So either it is individual or organizations, they simply have to follow this this link here, this page, and write on donate. And then if you have a bigger donation, mashallah, then obviously let me know, and then we can inshallah arrange a special program for you inshallah to recognize that donation as well. And also the hospital has, as I said, different levels of recognition of individuals and organizations as well. Although you'll be donating through this pledge, but your own individual recognition will be also displayed on the hospital wall. So I encourage all the individuals plus the businesses that you, if you want to please, inshallah, recognize your name as well for your business, because of course it's good for your promotion as well, but also your NIA is of course there. But sometimes commonly we know that the charity should not be when your right hand gives, the right, left hand should not know, right? But on the other side, there's examples from this Rasulullah's time that to encourage others, we are supposed to tell that we are giving this charity. So because just keep in the mind, your niyyah is that you are encouraging people with your donation. So your name should be there to encourage the people. So inshallah, we will recognize you whatever level you are. If you're giving 20,000, 100,000, even $1 million, I'm very confident our community, mashallah, like Brother Shakir gave more than $1 million in the hospital. And there are many other, mashallah, community members who can come forward in the $1 million. And also, I'm not, saying that rely on a dollar, $5, $10, $20. So don't underestimate that. The power of the small donation is much bigger. So I encourage that if you have a dollar, $5, $10, do it just with your niyyah. Inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you here in the hereafter, inshallah.
Awesome. That's amazing. And yes, and that's what we want to, of course, make sure we encourage everybody watching, whatever our capacities are, whether you are a student or a person who has a business or a person who's working or not working, whatever capacity you have, or a not-for-profit organization or charity, whatever contribution you're willing, able to make, definitely this is something, proud to be part of as individual and as a community. We want to be part of this historic initiative, inshallah. And as Brother Mufti, you mentioned, we all want to be part of something good, something historic that that we will be proud of, our next generation will be proud of, Canada will be proud of, and our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will be proud of, inshallah. So thank you for sharing such beautiful inspirational words with us today about this incredible project. Is there anything else in conclusion you want to share with us, with the community who's listening, about this project or anything else related to this as we conclude?
Absolutely. Good you asked that. I will encourage, especially this message is for the parents. As we said that the education starts from home. And charity starts from home as well. So encourage our youth, when parents want to give something, ask your youth, your son or daughter, to themselves to donate it in this cause, inshallah. You may be providing the money, but the let them do it themselves. This way you build their character. So when they grow up, when they become themselves, the parents or adults, then they will know the importance of charity in Islam. So that is something that is very important that I would like to share. The last thing I would also again emphasize that, because our leader, our mentor, our Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam is our role model, and this is all we are doing because he taught us like that. So that is the reason. And again, the not only that we are helping all the communities, and the hospital is the place where not only Muslims go, everybody goes, you know, whether you have a faith or you don't have a faith. I know you're Jews, Christians, Hindus, Sikhs, Buddhists, you name it. So we are helping the humanity. It's not only for Muslims. So that's why, and again, his name, inshallah, will be recognized with his hadith, will be put on the wall. And this is a big, you know, message, you know, to that this is the religion of peace and humanity and helping the humanity at large without any racism, without any discrimination.
That was that's great. Thank you so much, Brother Mufti. You are a source of inspiration for many of us, a lot of us, I would say. And so thank you so much for not only taking the time to share with us the inspirational story behind this historic contribution, but also, you know, we'd love to, inshallah, learn more about all the amazing interfaith work and civic engagement work you keep doing, and we encourage our community to keep supporting such initiatives like this, you know, pledge to the Trillium Hospital, as well as many other endeavors that are part of your work. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless this work and this effort. And we look forward to, inshallah, hearing more good news about such contributions, such campaigns in the near future, inshallah. So thank you.
I would say, Taha, thank you so much. And kind of you to remember to give me this opportunity to talk to your viewers. And again, you know, you've been always a great support, always. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and your family, you know, and your father, Brother Ghayyur, mashallah, you know. And, you know, thank you so much again for sending this message across. I think there'll be a lot many more occasions when we will meet and discuss about it, inshallah.
Of course, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. Thank you. So, folks, you are watching once again another edition of Canada Today Show on Muslim Network TV. Today, we were just talking to Brother Abdul Qayyum Mufti, who has been leading this project or campaign of fundraising for our hospitals for the past 10 years now, alhamdulillah, on behalf of the Muslim community. And inshallah, very soon we're going to be coming back with another episode. So with that, I wanted to thank Dawanet and Toronto Muslims for its support for marketing, and want to thank you, the audience, for watching. And if you ever have any ideas for stories that need to be told, or any topics you want us to cover over the next few weeks, please do reach out to us. Thank you for joining us once again. This is Taha Ghayyur on Canada Today. Look forward to seeing you. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.